What are the characteristics of black cotton soil?
What, how to overcome the difficulties of black cotton soil?
So in this lecture, we will see if black cotton soil is there and you are dealing with a machine foundation construction or any heavy type of foundation, or you can say you are constructing a bridge or abutment, then you are definitely suggest your under rim pile foundation. This is nothing but a deep type of foundation. When black cotton soil is there, water table is there, and SBC of your soil is not proper, then you can directly suggest a under rim pile foundation. Okay, so this is generally cast in situ concrete pile having one or more bulbs. Okay, so what is one or more bulbs? Bulbs like this. Okay, see that is figure A. You can see that this is vertical part, totally straight rectangular vertical part is known as a stem, as well as the bottom triangular part, which we have number A is the bulb. If your stem is dealing with a single bulb, then it become a single under rim pile foundation. And if your stem is dealing with a double bulb, then you can say double under rim pile foundation. Or you can say if a number of bulb is more than one, then you can also say it is a multi under rim pile foundation. Okay, so are you getting this? I hope you are getting this. Okay, so the form enlarging the bore hole for the pile stem by under rim rimming tool. These are under rimming tool is there to excavate your soil and insert your pile in the foundation. These piles, these piles find applications in widely varying situations in a different types of soil. Their foundations are required to be taken down to certain depth to avoid the undesirable effect of seasonable moisture changes, as in case of extensive soil or reach a strata, or to obtain the adequate capacity to the downward. See, if your soil is not enough to carry the your heavy structural load, then you should insert your pile up to the certain depth so that the undesirable settlement because of expansive soil, because of volumetric change in your soil, or because of seasonable moisture thing, hai na? So you should overcome that difficulty by using your under rim pile foundation. In figure, we will see in the figure, details of under rim pile foundation is given. When the pile has only one bulb, then it is known as a single rim pile. I have already told you. While the pile is having more than one bulb, then it is known as a multi under rim pile foundation. Okay. Generally, the diameter of under rim pile bulb is kept equal to 2.5 times the diameter of a pile stem. What is meant by pile stem? See in this figure, the vertical rectangular part you are seeing, that is nothing but your stem, as well as the bottom triangular portion you are seeing in figure A or in figure B. There are two bottom triangular portion on left part and right part, that is nothing but your bulb. Okay, these are the bulb, and it is always kept at a diameter of 2.5 times the diameter of your stem. If you are calculating your diameter of stem, you should calculate your diameter of stem from the end to end dimension in horizontal direction, end to end. Okay, 2.5 times the diameter of your vertical stem. However, it may vary from 2 to 3 times the vertical stem diameter if required, depending upon the design requirement. Though we are taking randomly or alternately or approximately 2.5 times diameter of stem, you can vary this quantity, or you can vary this diameter of your bulb, under rim bulb, based on your experience. If you are dealing with your design criteria, if 2 times, you can take 2 times. If 2.5 times, or you can also take 3 times. Okay. Now, we will see the details of your under rim pile bulb. In deep layer of expansive soil, you know better know that what is mean by expansive soil. The soil which give the volumetric change in your soil, volumetric, tremendous volumetric change because of moisture present in that. So that will become a expansive soil. And generally this problem will occur in a black cotton soil. The minimum length of pile required is 3.5 meter. What is the minimum length of your pile required in case of under rim pile foundation? Minimum 3.5 meter, where the ground movement become negligible. In shallow depth of expansive soil, the other poor soils, depending upon the load requirement, the length may be reduced up to the 50 centimeter in a stable zone. You can
reduce your you can reduce your stem length up to the 50 centimeter only. Means 0.5 meter. Means kitna 3.5 minus 0.5 centimeter. You can only do that much of change. Which means you will need to provide your minimum length up to 3. Or you can provide 3.5 meter where the ground movement is completely negligible. So the diameter of manually bored hole ranges from 20 centimeter to 37.5 centimeter. The diameter of bore hole is nothing but if you are inserting your bulb along with the stem into your excavated soil, the diameter you can also vary 20 centimeter to 37.5 centimeter. The spacing between the piles should be considered in relation to the nature of the ground. If you are providing group pile, if only one pile or two pile is not sufficient, you will need to provide in a group pile, then spacing of pile should be a basic criteria for your construction of your pile foundation. Okay, the types of piles and the manner in which the piles transfer the load to the ground. Generally, the center to center spacing of the under rim piles should not be less than 2 times DU. What is DU stands? It is nothing but under rim diameter. Under rim diameter means which diameter? It is the diameter of your bulb. Okay. So spacing should not be less than 2 times your DU. It may be reduced up to 1 DU when the reduction in a load carrying capacity is up to only 10%. Okay, if you are having a not very much load, it is somewhat a medium load, then you can reduce up to your length of your bulb or diameter of your bulb up to 1.5 times a DU. For the spacing of 2 times DU, the bearing capacity of pile group may be taken equal to the number of piles multiplied by the bearing capacity of individual piles. You can calculate the SBC of your soil by taking into the consideration of pile group, which is equal to the number of piles multiply the SBC of your individual pile. Okay, so if the adjacent piles are not different diameter, the average value of spacing should be taken. You can also take the, see, if you are providing a number of piles in your foundation, so it is not required that each and every pile is having the same dimension. It is not at all compulsory. You can vary your dimension based upon your experience or based upon your design. Okay, so it is not necessary to have each and every pile is having a same dimension diameter wise or length wise. You can change your diameter basic criteria based on your design. Okay, the maximum spacing of under rim pile should not exceed 2.5 meter, so that the avoid a heavy load capping the beams. In building, the piles should generally be provided under the wall junction to avoid a point load on beams. Positions of intermediate pile are then decided trying to keep the opening in a piles. Okay, if you wanted to inspect your pile after inserting into the ground, you can also keep their opening. So this part is now absolute. They are not providing any type of opening because directly they will give the moisture movement in your a pile will be taken place, and because of moisture movement, the water is always having the way. You know that water will always find a way, and if that water is inserted into the concrete will be started deteriorate. Okay, so this is about your under rim pile foundation. And also the one point you should remember, we have discussed the single rim pile foundation dimension. Means the stem length should be up to 2.5 meter, the diameter should be up to 2 to 3 times of your DU, where DU is nothing but your depth or diameter of your bulb. This is only in case of your single rim pile foundation. But if you are providing a double rim or multi rim pile foundation, the size should not be less than 30 centimeter diameter, and the center to center vertical spacing between the two under rim may be up to 1.5 times DU. While the pile is having 30 centimeter diameter and more, this distance may be reduced up to 2.5 times DU. You can see directly in this figure, if you are seeing figure number B, the distance, center to center distance between the two under rim bulb should be kept as a 1.5 times D, or you can reduce this spacing based on your experience. It is up to 1.25 times DU. DU is nothing but diameter of your bulb. Okay, so in figure B, you can see that the horizontal portion which is provided, that is nothing but rings. Rings are nothing but your stirrups portion in case of pile foundation. And the upper triangular is nothing but your shearing surface, which is subjected to the shearing surface. And the portion which is in between your both the bulb, that is nothing but the boring required for the first under rim, that is nothing but known as a boring required for the first under rim. And the second part is nothing but a second under rim bulb, first under rim bulb and second under rim bulb. Okay, so this is about the generally you are about the pile foundation in case of a double under rim bulb. Okay, this is about the pile foundation. And always remember, apart from this pile foundation, if vertical beam is also there, because we need to provide our plinth beam, so please, there should be a gap, air gap should be provided in case of that plinth beam and your pile foundation, so that the busting of your concrete should not happen, or the insertion of any extra material should not happen. The air gap, air movement should be there, so that your deterioration of concrete or a failure of your concrete or bending of your beam should not be happen. So hence you will need to provide your air gap. Okay, so this is very important point you should remember. And also one more important question is that the bulb is having an inclination to your horizontal steam. So the phi should be is ranging from 30 degree to 40 degree for du having t times d. What is du? Du is nothing but diameter of your bulb. What is d? D is nothing but depth of your stem. Are you getting this? Depth of stem means the rectangular portion is known as a depth of a stem, and du is nothing but your diameter of a bulb in case of under rim pile foundation. Okay, so the phi is also ranging from 40 degree to 50 degree for du having the dimension du equal to 2.5 times d. 50 to 60 degree when du is nothing but your 2 times of d. This is the basic question. And if you are seeing into diagram, d is nothing but it is given in the figure number B. D is nothing but diameter of your stem, and du is nothing but diameter of your bulb. Okay. So these are generally the single under rim pile and double under rim pile. Where to provide? When expansive soil is there, moisture content is present while excavation, or the heavy machinery foundation you will need to provide, then you can directly suggest your under rim pile foundation. Generally, expansion, moisture content, SBC is low. These are the basic problem we have seen in our last lecture in a black cotton soil. So this is the foundation under rim pile foundation. See the diagram. This diagram is very important. I will share this PDF to you. Okay. Under rim pile can be made up at a batter also. Okay. For sustaining the large lateral loads, thus making them suitable for tower footing, retaining walls and abutment. So where you can use your under rim pile foundation, it can be used under the tower footing, retaining walls footing, and abutment part is also you can going to use your under rim piles. Okay, so they have also been found useful for the factory building or machine foundations and the transmission line tower and the poles. If vertical pole is having the very heavy load, you can say if there is a concrete load, concrete pole, then these are subjected to very heavy load. So you can directly put up with a under rim pile foundation. In black cotton soil, see ya. In black cotton soil, the expansion soil, the under rim pile anchor structure of depth where the volumetric changes is seasonable, then the variation is negligible. So generally, you will need to provide your under rim pile in a volumetric change is changing of your soil, or the black cotton soil is there. I have already told you this thing. The under rim pile is a nominal rain force with 10 to 12 mm diameter only, having the longitudinal bar and 6 mm diameter of rings. Means you will need to provide your stirrup size up to only 6 mm diameter rings. Means you can say if the rings are there, you can see likewise our column, these are subjected to the rings and to prevent your buckling portion. So these are nothing but having the diameter of 6 mm diameter. It should be up to 6, not a 8, not a 10, not a 12. And if you are seeing the vertical dimension, which is nothing but in figure B or figure A, the bottom anchorage portion is given as a vertical longitudinal your diameter of bar should be up to 10 mm to 12 mm. So remember the diameter in case of pile foundation. What is the diameter of ring? It should be up to 6 mm. In case of pile under rim foundation, what is the diameter of your longitudinal bar? It should be up to 12 mm to 10 mm to 12 mm. Okay. And also the clear cover you should keep between the stem and your longitudinal reinforcement up to 4 cm only. Kidi, only you will need to provide up to 4 cm clear cover in case of under rim pile foundation. Though it is a single under rim or though it may be a double or multi under rim pile. Okay. So this is nothing but your about your pile foundation. Now you can see what are the how to calculate the load carrying capacity from the soil property of your under rim pile foundation. So there is a one formula for a clay soil. Q is nothing but AP and NC, CP, A alpha, NC, CA dash. These are nothing but formula. You should remember this formula for your exam point of view, because they might be asking you what is AP stands for, what is NC stand for, what is CP stands for. Okay, so you should know this formula. As well as we have done this formula somewhat like in Terzaghi's equation in unit number 3, the formula will remain same. NC, NQ and N gamma is nothing but your bearing capacity factor given by the Terzaghi. What is NC? NC is a bearing capacity factor usually taken as 1. AP is nothing but a cross-sectional area of your pile stem at a toe. Okay, CP is nothing but cohesion of soil around the toe. And AA, capital A, small a, is the suffix A, is given by pi by 4 du square minus d. What is du? Diameter of bulb. What is the diameter of your stem? Okay, so du is always greater than d. Always remember this basic term. And CA dash is nothing but the average cohesion of your soil around the rim pile bulb. AS dash is nothing but surface area of cylindrical circumscribing the under rims. Alpha is nothing but a reduction factor, usually taken as a 0.5 for clay soil. And CA is nothing but a average cohesion of soil along the pile stem. AS is nothing but surface area of the stem. If this problem is given to you, if in case of, as per your syllabus point of view, there is no problem, there are no numerical based on your under rim pile foundation, but if you are doing preparing for UPSC, then this problem is also there. These are very important in case of under rim pile foundation is very important in case of your competitive point of view. So if you want to prepare for that, you should remember this basic term and your basic formula. Okay, so this is about the clay soil. Likewise, the same formula is given for the, now the second formula is given for the sandy soil. The formula will become QU is nothing but pi by 4 into bracket du square minus d square, whole bracket complete, and again another in second bracket 1 by 2 du n gamma plus gamma nq summation of r is equal to 1 is to r equal to a and dr. Rest of the term you can see from the below figure. Plus pi by 4 d square into bracket 1 by 2 d gamma into n gamma plus gamma into df into nq plus 1 by 2 pi d gamma k tan delta into delta, d1 square, d2 square, df square minus dn square. So this is the general formula. You should remember this formula. The formula you should remember is only about the clay soil formula. Okay, because this... in a competitive exam, this question may be asked, solve the load carry or calculate the load carrying capacity of your clay soil in case of under rim pile foundation. So remember this formula. There might be a question in case of competitive exam. And sandy soil, you will need to write down this sandy soil formula for your third year syllabus point of view. There might be a question. Write down the different formula to calculate the load carrying capacity of soil in case of sandy or clay for under rim pile foundation. So remember these both formula, these are very important. Now the we will see what are the construction of you, what are the construction steps or construction procedure of your under rim pile foundation. The various stages involved in the construction of under rim pile foundations are, so these are the steps in case of construction of under rim pile. Take a screenshot of these steps. These are very important. The first step is a boring by auger. In a competitive exam, they will rearrange this A, B, C, D, E, and they will ask you put up this into a ascending order. So you should able to order that construction steps in case of underrim pile foundation. So number A is nothing but boring by augers. Number B is a underrimming by the underrimmer. C is nothing but a placing reinforcement cage in a position. D is a concreting of a pile. And E is nothing but concreting of pile cap, splint beam, and certain wall. These are the construction steps. You can say that these are the stages involved in the underrim pile foundation. As you can see in the figure, the equipment required for the construction of pile are the auger boring guide, spiral auger with an extension rod. We have seen this all the instrument in our unit number 1, where we have dealing with the soil exploration. Okay, underrimmer with a soil bucket, concreting funnel, a portal tripod hoist with winch is required specially for piles larger than 4 to 5 meter length and diameter larger than 37.5. So in this figure you can see A is nothing but your boring auger boring guides. Okay, boring by the auger is nothing but figure A. This is the first step of your pile foundation stages in the construction of your underrim. So figure B is nothing but your underrimming by the underrimmer. This is nothing but underrimming by the underrimmer. A rimmer is nothing but a bulb shape was there, and below that bulb shape there will be always provide a bucket so that excavation can be completely done through the your soil exploration. So this is nothing but second step. Now the third step is known as the placing of reinforcement cage in position. You will need to cast your You will need to provide your longitudinal bar and stirrups on the site in cast institute concrete by using your step number C, which is nothing but a concreting funnel will be there. By using the concreting funnel, you will need to provide, you will need to place your bars and rings at a proper position in case of your underrim pile foundation. Because we know that in underrim pile foundation, it is not possible to go inside the foundation and place the place your reinforcement detail like we are doing in our case of putting or your construction of your building. So it is not that type of structure. You will need to use construction funnel for your construction, for your putting your reinforcement in case of your underrim foundation. Now the D is nothing but a concreting of pile. You can do after placing reinforcement, you can do the concreting by using pipe concreting you can use, or pumpable concrete also you can use directly. You will need to insert your big hose or big nose into the concreting hole and into your pile hole, and directly you can concreting your you can directly pump your concrete by using under some pressure. Okay, this is nothing but a step number D. Now the next step is the concreting of pile cap, plinth beam, and curtain wall. You will need to cover that pile. You will need to cover that your underrim pile with a plinth beam over or a pile cap. If you are seeing this figure, this is covered with a beam, or this is also covered. You can also cover this top portion with a pile cap. Okay, so this is the last step. First of all, you will need to do the auger boring. That is nothing but excavation. After excavation, you will need to give your proper reinforcement at a proper position. After that, you will need to give the concreting to that pile portion. After that, you will need to provide a cap. Or you will need to provide a beam. Okay, beam or cap, you can say anything. You will need to provide a, you can provide both, or you can provide only one, either from them, beam or cap. Okay, this is about the stages in the construction of underrim pile foundation. Now, this is about your unit number 5. Now, we will see the unit number 6, which is nothing but a reinforcement in a soil. We will see the reinforcement, how to give the reinforced earth, how to give the reinforcement to the soil. Okay, as we are having today's is last lecture of our syllabus, we will complete the reinforced earth in this lecture itself. Okay, so why to provide the reinforcement to the earth? Or what is mean? We will see. The reinforced earth consists of compacted soil mass within which the reinforcing elements or membranes, usually in the form of horizontal strips or metal. If you are seeing this diagram, there are nothing but a horizontal strips or metal you can see. The magenta portion is nothing but a horizontal portion or a strip you will need to provide under your soil. This is become a your reinforced earth or reinforced soil. You can say reinforced earth or reinforced soil, such as GI steel, stainless steel or aluminum alloy, rods of metal, wire grids, fire glass. You can also use, these are the reinforced material to give the sufficient strength to your earth. Okay. The essential feature of reinforced earth is that friction develops between compacted layer of the earth and the reinforcing element. The soil transfers the force built up in the earth mass to the reinforcement by the means of this friction. See, as you are inserting your metal sheet or the steel sheet or GI sheet into the soil, there will be always a friction. There will be always a friction between your sheet and your soil. So that friction is used to transfer your load. That sheets are used to become a transfer your load and give the hard strata or a hard foundation, hard support to your foundation. So you will need to provide a reinforced earth. Okay. The soil transfer the force built up in the earth mass, the reinforcement by the means of friction. Thus, tension is developed in the reinforcement, and the modern form of application of reinforced earth was first applied by Mr. Henry Widel, who is the first constructed the major retaining wall in France in 1968. Okay, so Mr. Henry Widel is the first one who was the scientist who insert your metal sheet into the ground and name it as a reinforced earth. And also he has constructed one dam in France in 1968 by using this same concept. Okay, so it should be noted that the technique is subjected to the patent by the Widel. Widel is the name of scientist and the reinforced earth company. The term reinforcers is being traded as a trademark. Okay. The basic principle behind the incorporating of reinforcement member into the soil mass is same as thus utilized in the design of reinforced concrete. See, in case of concreting structure, why we provide a steel in case of concrete? Because we know that concrete is strong in compression but weak in tension, and to give that tension we will need to provide your steel. Likewise, the same formula or the same concept he has been used while constructing this dam or while constructing this concept or by giving this concept. The metal sheet or the rods are only being used for the taking the tensile load or giving the tensile strength to your structure. Okay. The membrane are also used to provide the tensile strength in case of earth mass in location where the shear stresses are neglected. Okay, the provision of membrane leads to the redistribution of stresses internally within each of the membrane encapsulated layer. Okay, encapsulated layer means on a single layer. You will need to keep that layer at a particular distance from one by one. Okay, so the timing running out. The next part we will see in the next lecture. By the time, if you are facing some difficulty, you can ask me.